सब्जेक्ट लॉजिस्टिक एंड सप्लाई चेन मैनेजमेंट, सब टॉपिक ट्रांसपोर्टेशन. इन दिस वी आर गोइंग टू कवर कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ ट्रांसपोर्टेशन, ट्रांसपोर्ट फंक्शनैलिटी, प्रिंसिपल ऑफ ट्रांसपोर्टेशन, पार्टिसिपेंट इन ट्रांसपोर्टेशन. कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ ट्रांसपोर्टेशन. द रोल ऑफ ट्रांसपोर्टेशन इन लॉजिस्टिक हैज चेंज ड्रामेटिकली ओवर द लास्ट 4 decades. Prior to transportation deregulation, the purchase of transportation would be liked to buying a commodity such as coal or grain. There are very little difference between transport supplier in term of product, service or price. Transportation deregulation in 1980 introducing price flexibility and significantly increased the range of service transportation company could provide customer. Transportation refer physical movement of product from one place to another. Today, a wide range of transportation is available to support supply chain logistic. For example, logistic manager may integrate private with for hire transportation to reduce total logistic cost. Many for hire carrier offer a wide variety of value added service such as product sortation, sequencing and customized freight delivery and presentation. Technology has enhanced a real-time visibility of the location of freight throughout the supply chain, advanced information concurrent delivery, precise product delivery, reduced inventory, storage and material handling. As a result, the value of transportation has become greater than simply moving product from one location to another. Now let's see transportation function in logistic and supply chain. Transportation functionality is divided into product movement and product storage. Let's see product movement first. Whether in a form of material, component, work in process or finished good, the basic value provided by transportation is to move inventory to specified destination. The primary transportation value proposition is product movement throughout the supply chain. The performance of transportation is vital to procurement, manufacturing, and customer accommodation. Transportation also plays a key role in the performance of reverse logistics. Without reliable transportation, most commercial activity would not function. Transportation consumes time, financial, and environmental resources. Transportation has a restrictive element because inventory is generally inaccessible during the transportation process. Inventory captive in the transport system is referred to as in-transit inventory. Naturally, when designing logistics system, managers strive to reduce in-transit inventory to a minimum. Advancement in information technology have significantly improved access to in-transit inventory and arrival status of shipment by providing exact location and arrival time. Transportation also uses financial resources. Transportation costs result from driver labor, vehicle operation, capital invested in equipment and administration. In addition, product loss and damage are significant costs. Transportation impact environmental resources both directly and indirectly. In indirect term, transportation represent one of the largest consumer of fuel and oil. Although the level of fuel and oil in consumption has improved as a result of more fuel efficient vehicle, total consumption remains high. Indirectly, transportation impacts the environment through consumption, air pollution, and noise pollution. Next is product storage. A visible of transportation is a performance of a product storage. While a product in a transportation vehicle, it is being stored. Transport vehicle can also be used for product storage at shipment origin or destination, but they are comparatively expensive storage facility. Product storage is expensive in transport vehicle, but sometimes keeping overall cost in mind, This is adopted in situations such as keeping overall cost in it. This is adopted in situations such as the cost of unloading and reloading the product in the warehouse is more expensive. The destination warehouse has limited storage capacity. Therefore, the transportation vehicle is being used as a temporary storage option. At other times, temporary storage is used due to diversion. This occurs when an original delivery destination is changed while the inventory is in transit or movement. Example, suppose a product is initially scheduled to be delivered from Pune to Mumbai. But during the delivery process, it is determined that Nasik warehouse is in great need of product. The product would be delivered to the alternative destination of Nasik. Conclusion, thus the major objective of transportation is to move the product from an origin location to a prescribed destination while minimize temporal, financial and environmental resource cost. Loss and damage expenses must also be minimized. At the same time, the movement must take place in a manner that meets customer demand regarding delivery performance. Transport principle, economy of scale. Transport principle are divided into two, that is economy of scale and economy of distance. So let's first see the economy of scale. Economy of scale in transportation is a cost per unit of weight decrease as the size of a shipment increase. For example, truckload shipment utilizing an entire trailer capacity have a lower cost per unit of weight. Then, smaller shipment that utilize a limited portion of vehicle capacity. It is also generally true that larger capacity transportation vehicles such as rail and water vehicle are less costly per unit of weight than smaller capacity vehicles such as truck and airplanes. Transportation economy of scale exists because fixed costs associated with transportation, a load is allocated over the increased weight. Fixed costs include administration related to scheduling, cost of equipment, time of position, vehicles for loading or unloading, and invoicing. Such costs are considered fixed because they do not vary with the shipment size. For example, the fixed cost of delivering 10 kg of goods and 1000 kg of goods will be the same. Economy of distance. Economy of distance refers to decreased transportation costs per unit of weight as distance increase. For example, a shipment of 800 miles will cost less to perform than two shipments of the same weight, each moving 400 miles. Transportation economy of distance is often referred to as the tampering principle, since rate tamper reduces. That is reduced with increasing distance. The rationale of distance economics is similarly to economics of scale. Specifically, longer distance allow fixed costs to be spread over more miles, resulting in lower per mile charges. So we can conclude that these principles are important consideration when evaluating alternative transportation strategy. The objective is to maximize the size of the load and the distance that is shipped while still meeting customer service expectations. Now let's see participants in transportation. First is shipper or originating party or consignor. Shipper and consignee have a common interest in moving goods from origin to destination with a given time at the lowest cost. Service related to transportation includes specified pickup and delivery time, predicted transit time and zero loss and damages, as well as accurate and timely exchange of information and invoicing. Receiver, destination party, consignee. Consignee is a person to whom the goods are sent. They may be wholesaler, retailer or a final customer. Role and perspective of receiver is receiving the good from original to destination in shortest possible time and lowest cost. receiving the goods without any loss or damage, accurate and timely exchange of information relating to status of goods. Next is carriers and agent. The carrier is the service provider or a transporter who carry the shipment from the shipper to receiver. The carrier, a business that performs a transportation service, desires to maximize its revenue for movement while minimizing associated cost. As a service business, carriers want to charge their customer the highest rate possible while minimizing labor, fuel, and vehicle costs required to complete the movement. To achieve this objective, the carrier seeks to coordinate pickup and delivery times to group or consolidate many different shipper freight into movement that achieve economy of scale and distance. Broker and freight forward are transport agent that facilitates carrier and customer matching. A more recent development has been the emergence of internet or online broker that match carrier capacity and shipper requirement. Next is the public. The final transportation system participant, the public, is concerned with transportation accessibility, expense and effectiveness, as well as environment, security and safety standard. The public indirectly create transportation demand by purchasing good. While minimizing transportation cost is important to consumer, concern also involve environmental impact and safety. The effect of air pollution and oil spoilage is a significant transportation related social issue. The cost, environment impact and safety is ultimately paid by consumer. Next is government. The government has vested interest in transportation because of the critical importance of reliable service to economic and social well-being. Government is a major participant in transportation decision. Government desire a stable and efficient transportation environment to transport economic growth. Because of a direct impact of transportation on economic success, government have traditionally been very involved in oversight of carrier practice. Government historically regulated carriers by restricting market they would service and approving prices they would charge. Government also promote carrier development by supporting research and providing right of way such as roadways and airport. In some countries, government maintain absolute control over market, service and rates. Such control allow governments to have a major influence on the economic success of regions, industry and firms. So we can conclude that transportation relation is complex because of interaction between the parties. This will lead to frequent conflict between parties, with a micro interest, shipper, consignees and carrier, as well as a parties with micro interest, government and the public. For the more management notes, please prefer subscribing and click on notification bell. Thank you.